For the big picture, Melissa, is that we are tightening the screws around Iranian interest and deployment in the region. This explains why Tehran is trying to do those small strikes for now. And in this case, I would argue that they knew what they were doing. They were targeting a drone, unmanned drone, because they know that if the American public would see American victims, then that would give the president a lot of fuel to be responding. So at the end of the day, the White House will decide at what time, where, and how to respond to this Iranian attack.
So, I mean, they want to provoke, but not too much. What's the value in that?
They need to continue to provoke so that their public, and remember, they control four regimes in the region, Iraq, Syria, Lebanon, Yemen, all these countries will apprise if they see that Iran has been weakened. So they're going to continue to show strength, but not beyond the red line, which is to harming Americans. They could shoot anytime or, bomb anytime our forces in Iraq. They're very careful about that, but they're going to continue with those small kind of actions.
What do you think the appropriate response is?
Well, there are a lot of scenarios. It depends on the big picture, on what the administration wants to do. If it feels it has all the strength, the political strength, unity, and resources to do a large scale against Iranian military, not necessarily on the ground or from the ground, then they can. But if they feel that politically they don't have that strength, they don't have that backing at this point in time, we will have to respond, but not to trigger a much wider conflict that we're not ready for now.
Yeah. If they respond with force, what happens from there? What does the U.S. gain out of that? And what's the impact on, everyone's relationship in the region?
Look, the Iranians have to do this because of their equation. They have to show strength. We have to respond somehow because we have allies on the ground as well, and because the Iranians will go one inch further. And, of course, because the rules of engagement. If you are attacked, now this is a drone. Next time it could be a manned vehicle or a tank or any other thing. So we are in a very delicate situation where we have to respond, but it doesn't have to be the way the Iranians would expect it, meaning going back to the base where those missiles were launched. Doesn't have to be that way. That's what the administration is discussing as we speak right now.
Yeah, I mean, they must expect a response of some type. So, I don't know. I mean, do you go bigger or smaller than that? Do you go bigger to kind of push them back on their heels? It's hard to understand the chess game here if everybody kind of knows what should come next.
You called it exactly what it is. It's a huge chess game. They know that they're going to be a strike. They want to try to use it to counter-strike and to show that they are strong on the ground. But they have another message. They know that we have political divisions in Washington, and they feel that between now, if they can withstand between now and, let's say, the end of the year, next year is a campaign elections year, so they are trying to show strength to a certain point, not to be hit back against by us with a full-fledged capacity of the American military.
What's the price of not responding?
That would be bad. If we don't respond in a way or another, maybe through allies or others, then this is going to encourage the Iranians. We are locked, both of us, in a game whereby they will strike. We have to counter-strike, but not to go full-fledged because we don't have that readiness, I suppose, on the political level.